Hey everyone, and welcome back to the Sawickipedia. Today we're looking at the different error codes that may be thrown up by your Bosch, Siemens, Neff, Kenmore dishwasher. There's going to be separate videos for each error code, so I'll split these up into a big playlist so you can look at your particular error code without having to look through all the other crap about the rest of the error codes. I'd suggest hitting the subscribe button now just so you can easily come back to these videos whenever you need to. It's going to make it a lot easier to find them for you. But apart from that, we'll get straight into it. The E23, E24 and E25 errors relate to an issue with the dishwasher outlet. So first thing to do would be to check the outlet hose, make sure there are no kinks or blockages. Beyond that, we can remove the front panel and the bottom plate, base plate, and just check for any issues inside. Okay, so just a couple of things to check before you go pulling everything apart. Obviously check the drain filter and make sure there's nothing blocked up in here. Just be careful because there may be broken glass down in there if that's happened. And also check the other areas for any blockages. Down the back there is the dryer fan outlet, so make sure that's not blocked up. And if everything's clear there, just double check your water inlet and outlet pipes. Just be aware that water's likely to come out when you remove these. So this is the water outlet or drain pipe. Everything looks clear there. Just remember to fasten that clip back up. Otherwise you might make quite a mess. And the other thing to check would be the inlet pipe. I'll just turn it off and pull that out just so we can have a closer look. And once again, keep in mind, water will definitely come out of this one. As you can see, there's a filter in the end of it which does also come out. So just double check that that's all clear and everything in the pipe looks clear. There is also another filter in there which does not come out, so don't try and pull it out. But once you've established that everything's all good there, double check that the error code's still present. And if so, we'll move on to the next step. All right, now before we do anything else, just make sure that the power to the dishwasher is turned off and also the water to the dishwasher is also turned off. If you've got an inbuilt unit, you will have to remove your kickboard in order to access the bottom of the dishwasher. So in order to remove the front panel, you need a Torx T15 bit. You can pick these up from your local hardware store or electronics hobbyist store. So open up the front of the dishwasher and you'll find a total of 6 Torx bits around the back here. There are also a few up the front that holds the control panel on, but you don't need to remove those. So just remove these 6 Torx bits or Torx screws. Alright, once they're out, close the door back up, grab around the bottom at the sides and just pull outwards. Alright, and now you'll have access to these screws at the bottom here. So again, they're Torx T15 bits. and remove those. And then you can just pull this out. Just be careful because it is pretty sharp. And remove this sound deadening material. And now you've got access underneath. So the E23 arrow relates to your drain pump, which is down here. So just double check that it's connected properly. You can also check the resistance if you've got a multimeter handy. We'll just have a look now if I can manage to get the probes in there. Get probed. So we're getting about 90 ohms from the drain pump. So if you get a reading that's completely different, maybe indicate an error with the drain pump, in which case you'll have to remove it and likely replace it. Just check the drainage pipe here and make sure it's not clogged up or anything or leaking. And it's firmly connected as well. That's about it for this video. I hope it's helped you out. The only thing I'd ask in return is for you to subscribe to this channel, which you can find a link to in the bottom corner of this video. There's also another one popping up in the top corner of your screen somewhere around now. So as always, thanks for watching this Wikipedia. Please hit the like button and you can leave me a comment down below. As always, thanks for watching. See you later.